This is the story of the Apollo 11 moon landing in 1969. You could say it all started with what people called the space race between the USA and the Soviet Union. The Soviets got off to a flying start in 1957 when they launched a satellite called Sputnik into orbit around the Earth. The US was freaked out. They had to get serious about space exploration. And a year later, they set up NASA, which stands for National Aeronautics and Space Administration. But before they could really get started, the Soviets wowed the whole world by sending the first man into space in 1961. Yuri Gagarin orbited the Earth in his Vostok spacecraft to everyone's amazement. This focused American minds. The following year, President Kennedy set the goal of landing a man on the moon by the end of the decade, barely 8 years away. They didn't even have any of the modern technology we use today. Tough challenge.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Meanwhile, the Soviets just kept going with their space program, sending the first woman into space in 1963. By now, the US was seriously on it. They started building a team of what would amount to 400,000 people with an average age of only 27 years old to get a man to the moon before the Soviets got there first. A bunch of these smart young people would eventually end up in Houston's Mission Control Center for the Apollo 11 mission, guiding the astronauts to the moon touchdown. Three space programs, Mercury, Gemini, and the most famous of all, Apollo, saw the US develop their knowledge of space exploration. A bit like a kid learning and doing homework, these projects allowed them to develop, practice, and test again and again all the equipment and skills you need to get a man safely on the moon. Like sending a rocket into orbit, perfecting the docking maneuver, doing tasks outside the spacecraft, and checking how long astronauts could comfortably stay in space. Wernher von Braun was the man who built the massively powerful Saturn V rocket used to send Apollo 11 on its 250,000-mile journey to the moon. He was a brilliant German engineer who had been grabbed by the Americans at the end of the Second World War, where he had been working on rocket design for the Nazis. But the US knew early on they could use his rocket-building skills. The Saturn V rocket that powered Apollo 11 was made up of three stages that fell away after they'd been used. The first stage burned for about 3 minutes, shooting Apollo 42 miles into the sky. The second stage took it 100 miles above the Earth. Next, stage 3 carried Apollo into the moon's orbit before it dropped away. Now what was left was the lunar module, callsign Eagle, and the command and service module, callsign Columbia. Watch the real launch on July 16, 1969.
12, 11, 10, 9, ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, all engine running. We have a liftoff. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
You may well know the Apollo crew. Neil Armstrong became the first man to walk on the moon, followed by his fellow astronaut Buzz Aldrin. Don't forget Michael Collins, who circled the moon in the command capsule while his friends were busy down below. Probably the most dangerous part of the whole mission was the 13 minutes it took the astronauts to get down to the moon's surface in the Eagle. They nearly ran out of fuel because they couldn't find a good spot to touch down. And when Armstrong stepped out onto the lunar surface, it was watched by over 600 million people around the world.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
After 22 hours on the moon, the Eagle lifted back up to connect with Mike Collins in Columbia, circling overhead. Once all three astronauts were safely back in the command capsule, they started their journey home, splashing down in the Pacific Ocean on the 24th of July, 1969. The moon landing is about so many things. Setting a goal, realizing an impossible dream, it's about grit, determination, and a solid commitment. Today, it remains one of man's greatest achievements and stands to remind us of what we can do.